think about Martin Luther King Jr., you have to think about his purpose and his promise, his commitment and his compassion. In addition, your thoughts may travel to his desire and his dedication, not only for advancing the rights of African Americans, but for everyone. And you know, the principles that govern Martin Luther King's life are not much different from the principles that each of you as students are learning and hopefully embracing as you walk the halls and beautiful campus of the Columbus School for Girls. The goals of Columbus School for Girls are not dissimilar goals, and the mission of Columbus School for Girls is not a different mission than that sought by Martin Luther King, for not only his children, but for all children. You are encouraged as girls and young women to discover your distinctive potential and to strive for excellence. Is this not what Martin Luther King Jr. envisioned for you when he spoke the renowned words in his great speech, "I Have a Dream"? And please know that Martin Luther King Jr. didn't dream in black and white. He dreamed in full Technicolor, in HD, high definition. He dreamed in 3D. At least in part because of the actions of Martin Luther King and those who fought alongside of him, you not only can dream, but you can have your dream fulfilled. As Martin Luther King envisioned, you have the opportunity to be the very, very best individual that you could be. Irrespective of the color of your skin or the fact that you were born female instead of male, irrespective of where you were born or what family you were born into, the opportunities that will be open to you are a function of not only the education you're receiving at Columbus School for Girls, but also because of sacrifices made by men and women who held values, dreams, and passions and convictions similar to Martin Luther King Jr. No, Dr. King once said that intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. And let me reiterate, each of you is living the dream. The dream that you will not be judged by the color of your skin or your eyes or your hair or by the place of birth of your parents. You will not be judged by the amount of money in your family or by your ability to shoot a basketball or swing a golf club. You will be judged by your character. You will be judged by your commitment. You will be judged by your compassion and convictions.